Hypothesis testing for a population mean, part 2. To improve fuel efficiency and reduce pollution, the owners of a trucking fleet decide to install a new fuel catalyst in all of his semi trucks. He feels that the catalyst will increase the number of miles per gallon. Before the installation, his trucks had a mean gas mileage of 5.6 miles per gallon. A random sample of 12 trucks after the installation gave the following gas mileages. Assume the conditions for testing the hypothesis are satisfied. Does the evidence suggest that the fuel catalyst is effective? Use a 0.05 level of significance. So our first question to ask ourselves, is this a test for a population proportion or is this a test for population mean? Since clearly the data is quantitative, this involves a population mean. We also see the word mean written in the problem, so that's a red flag that this is a test involving a mean. So this test involves the six steps as before. Step 1, the null and the alternative. Step 2, the alpha level. Step 3, we compute the test statistic. So we need to know X bar. We need to know what is the assumed population mean. What's the sample standard deviation? And what's the sample size? Next, we compute the p-value. Number 5, we compare the p-value to the alpha level. If we do not reject the null, there is not sufficient evidence for the claim. If we do reject the null and conclude the alternative, there is sufficient evidence for the claim. And number 6, we state the conclusion using our decision in step 5. And again, we always start with the alpha level, then we state if there is sufficient or there is not sufficient evidence for the claim. And again, the claim is the alternative. So let's begin. So let's identify information that is given in the problem. We see that 5.6 mpg is going to be the assumed population mean. Next, we know the sample size is 12, and we know that it is a right-tailed test because we want to test, is the catalyst effective? And effective means that it's going to increase the miles per gallon. So increase means a right-tailed test. And we're also given an alpha level. Now, we do not know what is the sample mean or the sample standard deviation, but we can have Statcrunch compute that for the data. So in Statcrunch, input the data, the 12 values. Next, you want to go to Summary Stats. Then choose Columns, select the variable, and hit Compute. This is the output. We see the sample size is 12. The sample mean, X bar, is 6.31. We see the sample standard deviation is 0.357 approximately. And the standard error is 0.108, and that is the sample standard deviation divided by the square root of the sample size. Step 1. So our parameter is the population mean. So the symbol will be mu. The null will be, we assume that the mean is equal to 5.6 miles per gallon. The claim is that the mean is greater than 5.6 miles per gallon. And this is a right-tailed test. Step 2, the alpha level is 0.05. Step 3, Statcrunch calculated the value of the sample mean, sample standard deviation, and the sample size. Putting these values into the test statistic for T, we have these values. Computing the numerator and the denominator, and again, this is the standard error, we have 0.708 divided by the standard error, 0.108333, rounded off. And we see rounded to two decimal places. This gives us a test statistic of 6.54. Again, I highly suggest letting StatCrunch actually compute this. But if you want to verify, that's fine. So next, we will put this data in StatCrunch and have it verify that the test statistic is 6.54 and to compute the p-value for step number 4. Here we are in StatCrunch. Now, since we have the data inputted, we could go to Stat, t-stats, because we're doing a population mean, one sample with summary, and then input the value of X bar, the value of S, and the value of N. But a shortcut to that is, since we have raw data, we could just simply say with data, and StatCrunch will compute those values for us. So I'm going to select that. We have to select the column. We have to input the value for the assumed population mean, which is 5.6. The default is a two-tailed test. We're doing a right-tailed test, so we choose greater than. And like before, for the optional graphs, I'm going to click p-value plot. Now hit compute. So again, this is our null and alternative. This matches what we want. Here again is the sample mean. StatCrunch computed a sample mean. There's the standard error, which is S divided by square root of N. Here's our test statistic, 6.54 rounded off. And that's with 11 degrees of freedom. And our p-value is less than 0.0001. If I click this icon, we can have a visual of the p-value and the test statistic. Clearly, this is very far away from the assumed mean, and the p-value is less than 1 out of 10,000. So let's go back to the problem. So StatCrunch gives us a p-value of less than 0.0001, and since this is a right tail, this would be our shaded in region. It's very, very, very small. So this is a very unusual result if the true mean is equal to 5.6. So step 5, comparing the p-value in step 4 to the alpha level in step 2, we make this statement. Because the p-value, which is less than 0.0001, is less than alpha, which is 0.05, we reject the null that is equal to 5.6, and we conclude H1, the alternative, and that's the mean is greater than 5.6 miles per gallon. So if the p-value is low, H of O must go. We're going to reject this and conclude the alternative, that the average is more than 5.6 miles per gallon. Step 6, because we rejected HO, there will be sufficient evidence for the claim. At the 0.05 level of significance, there is sufficient evidence to indicate that the fuel catalyst appears to be effective in improving gas mileage. Another way we could say that is there is sufficient evidence to indicate that the population mean is greater than 5.6 miles per gallon. Thanks for watching.